This is day two of my rudder project. This is the assembly that I built yesterday. I'm checking now that it has some interference problems here. It cannot rotate fully to the horizontal because it has some interference with the blade with the fiberglass block. So I'm going to be cutting here a little just to allow it to fully, you know, pass. And I also going to make a hole here for a rudder bolt. It's a quarter of an inch stainless steel bolt. And the original stud that the wilderness rudder has, you see that there is this little hole there. Well, they put a pin there to keep it in place. I'm going to use a lock nut because I'm using this threaded bolt. So that will, you know, be more than enough. The lock nuts, nylon lock nuts. I will be replacing some of the nuts that I just use here, yes, to check the assembly. Those are great to keep in place all the parts. And that's what I'm going to be doing right now. I already enlarged that notch, and then as you can see, the rudder can rotate freely to the horizontal position. Next I'm going to be doing the hole, and I will leave the block together with this aluminum part, so the hole will pass through this aluminum bar, and it will be perfectly aligned. Using a 9/32 drill bit, I'm going to drill the hole. I already drilled the pilot hole for the rudder bolt. I already drilled the hole, trespassing this aluminum bar. And I'm going to be checking now if it's yeah, it's perfect. I'm going to have an issue here with the head of the bolt, so because the blade, once is rotated to the horizontal, will land here. So I'm going to enlarge the hole right where the head is. So I will make a hole bigger on the fiberglass block to allow this to go in. I just enlarged the hole, as you can see, so the bolt will go through it and the head will be just flush, so the blade won't, you know, touch the head of the bolt. To enlarge the bolt, I'll use this tool. It's commonly used to enlarge holes or to make holes on wood too, or you can use it on fiberglass too. I just enlarged these two holes that are used for the cables that will raise or lower the blade rudder. Also enlarge these two holes on the size of the rudder assembly. And I was checking, I just put the bolt there. As you see, it has two washers and a lock nut that I will explain how this is used later on. So I'm going to start putting everything together to see how it fits. And then later on, I will start what we're finalizing the bracket that will be attached to the kayak. Always happen. I already made the assembly. Everything fits very good, and now I'm going to cut this extra bolt just flush with the lug nut using
saw.
I just cut the group here on the top of the rotor bolt in order to allow to use a flat screwdriver and hold it in place while tightening the lock nut that is at the bottom of the bolt. Now I'm going to enlarge the two holes that has the bracket that attached to the kayak at the stern using a 1/4 inch drill bit. The two holes are ready. I'm just going to try fit this here to align with the existing holes that the kayak has at the stern. And also I'm going to enlarge this hole for the rotor bolt. Already made the holes of the bracket, so I'm going to proceed to install it to the stern of the kayak using the existing bolts. And the bracket is firmly attached to the kayak. Now I'm going to try fit the rudder to see how it works. Well, everything seems to be working very well. The rudder also rotates till the horizontal position. Later on I will need to make something here to hold it in place, a V-shaped block or something. I also noticed that, as I said before, the rudder cannot rotate farther than the position, because then we are going to be hitting the stern of the kayak. So we are going to make a hole here and put a bolt there that will be kind of a stop to the rudder to avoid it hitting the kayak. So I already put the bolt in, the top bolt, and it seems to be working very well. Well, now I'm going to start working on the other parts that have not been doing anything so far, and those are the pedal or the rotor tracks. I'm going to be installing them, and also passing all the wires that control the rotor, as well as the required wires or ropes that are going to be used to raise and lower the rotor. I'm going to start installing the rotor control track, the one that has the pedals. And first we need to locate where I'm going to install those tracks. So normally what we are going to be looking at is for a mark that shows a location where the original tracks are installed. These are different, these are not the Wilderness or Harmony brand tracks, so we're going to see if we can find first the mark and then see how from there we can measure. Maybe I will need to lower the kayak to the floor and then see what's the best position, you know, depending on the length of the in my case, I mean a middle-sized person, so it should be or should work for a short person or a kid and a tall person, that this track will move to the last position there. So we're going to find that marker.